Hello everyone, and I am really pleased to have with me Martyn Edwards, the Director of Marketing and Advancement at Loughborough University, UK. My name is Amit Chaturvedi. I'm Director of Client Relations at IDP South Asia, and with me I also have Raunak Hede. Raunak is a current student at the Loughborough University. He's from India, and briefly he did tell me that he's extremely happy and enjoying his stint at the university. I'm sure Raunak will come to you and talk about your experience also. And the objective of this discussion basically for our students is to give them an understanding of how things are shaping up at UK as destination for education. We have someone extremely experienced in Martyn who has seen a lot in terms of how things have changed over the years and how things have shaped for students over the years. And I'm sure his insights will be really helpful for our prospective students who are looking at UK as the first choice for education, or students who have any kind of a doubt with regard to be it quality of education, be it support received from the institution. I know I can be as vocal around all this, but it'll be great to hear from Martyn. So thank you, Martyn, and thank you, Raunak, for joining us. My first question, Martyn, would be, we all speak very well, very high about UK as choice of destination. How would you look at UK in the current situation? What would you say to students who are yet considering or possibly have made offers or an application? What would you say to them?
So thank you, Amit. It's a real pleasure to speak to you today as well. As you know, I've been traveling to India for almost 20 years now. It's always a pleasure to be in India. And I was there a few months ago. The first thing I want to say is really that you know, the UK doesn't have a monopoly on quality. There are lots of fantastic universities in India. I've been fortunate to visit quite a number of them in the IITs in Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai. I've been to private universities like Symbiosis in Pune. So I don't want to pretend that India itself has some fantastic universities. But obviously, there's a real fact that the UK, despite being, you know, a relatively small country compared to, say, the US, with, you know, maybe far fewer universities in the US. So the UK has around 160. The US has over 4,000. But still, the UK has this long-standing reputation for the high quality of its universities. And I think a really important reason for that, in part, is because our universities are public. They have their quality of teaching and research independently tested regularly on behalf of the government. And we also, of course, have some of the oldest universities in the world as well. And because of this proud history and this sort of tradition of excellence, we are known globally for producing graduates that have gone on to be incredibly successful and have the skills and the mindset that employers and global corporates, both in India but across the world, they want to hire UK graduates into their workforce. And a degree from the UK, whether that's an undergraduate bachelor degree, a master's, or a PhD, is respected and recognised globally. And I think one great piece of evidence to demonstrate this is an annual survey called the Soft Power Index from the Higher Education Policy Institute, which is independent. And that shows that of the 195 countries in the world, over a quarter, so 27%, have a senior leader who was educated in the UK. And that can be a monarch, it can be a president or a prime minister. So despite being quite a small country, really, that quality, that over quantity, I think, shines through. And as for Loughborough, you know, we're part of that proud tradition. We're ranked top 10 in all the UK major league tables. So right up there with Cambridge, with Oxford, LSE, UCL, Imperial, St. Andrews, etc. We are in that high quality group of global university brands. And we also have two very distinctive campuses, which I think I'm going to talk about a little bit later. So Loughborough's very proud. I'm very proud to work in the UK higher education system. And I think that global reputation for not just a few years, but decades and centuries is still true today because of the fact that UK graduates are so sought after by companies, you know, both in India, but across the world as well.
I agree with you. I think we know and we understand that the degrees awarded are globally accepted. And I am very hopeful students who are tuning into this conversation will understand the fact that this is not just an experience which they'll have for a year or maybe 3 years, but this is a lifetime experience of you know, getting into a world-class university and having a degree which will, of course, give them a lifelong advantage of winning a round. Now, other thing which I'll come to you, and I'll have Raunak also to come in, and because he is pursuing a distinct subject there. We do see a choice of subject change, or should I say the preference of subjects changing in terms of student choices. Loughborough, of course, offers a very wide variety of programs, but not just Loughborough, but if we talk more in terms of UK as a destination of education, how would you look at how institutions are supporting, how industry is looking at it? What's your take on that?
So I think that's a really good question. And I think one of the good things, one of the important things about UK universities, not just Loughborough, is that each university, pretty much every year, reviews its curriculum, reviews the programs, even the faculties that it provides. And that's really just to ensure that the program we offer is what the outside world needs. You know, there's some huge global challenges, which we may come across onto later, around, you know, the climate, around inequality, around health and well-being. So we are always looking at the latest reports and trends from government, both in the UK, but globally, you know, from big organizations, like maybe the World Health Organization, the World Bank, and different industries and businesses, to make sure that, you know, what they're predicting. So not just the jobs now or in a year's time, but what we call the jobs of the future. So what is the UK going to need? What is India going to need? What is the world going to need? What sort of jobs? And some of these jobs don't exist yet, but they certainly will in 5, 10, 15 years time. So this is a really big part of what universities do. And at Loughborough, as is often the case in many universities, it's led at the highest level. So we have a Pro Vice Chancellor for Education and Student Experience, who is the senior professor. And they look at this, they look at the data, they work with my team, they look at the market research, and we try and predict, you know, not just what the jobs are going to be, but then how do our degrees need to adapt and evolve to give the students the skills that they need to be successful when they find a job, but more importantly, to help society and to help the world really cope with some of these challenges. And as I mentioned earlier, I think another important thing about the UK is that because most of, if not almost all, our universities are public, there's a lot of scrutiny from the government about the degrees we offer, about the employability of graduates, how many get jobs after 6 months, what their starting salaries are there enough skilled workers in certain jobs and sectors in the workforce, and really about the return on investment and value for money generally of universities. So I think that benefits international students, it benefits Indian students, because it means that UK universities can't be complacent. They really have to listen to industry, listen to governments. So just to conclude, really, that sense of what we offer, our academic offering, it's very carefully managed at a strategic level. And all universities take that very seriously, which then obviously benefits students as well.
True. And I'd like to bring in Raunak here on this point. Raunak, my question is similar to what I asked Martyn, and if you can comment, because you chose to study in UK. You chose to pursue a program at Loughborough. So if you can just briefly narrate your experience of what made you choose UK and Loughborough both.
Just before I get to that, I was looking at other places as well, but there was one very specific aspect which was not available at other universities, and that was to do with the course content. So specifically, my course is Robotics, Mechatronics, and Control Engineering. It's an integrated master's degree, but it didn't start out that way. It started out with me signing up for a bachelor's, and then I actually enjoyed the program quite a lot and decided to extend it by another year after my placement. However, when I initially chose the course, it was because the order of modules was such that the electronics and software came first and the mechanical knowledge. And I think that's actually something that a lot of students don't look into, because they're focusing almost solely on where the course ranks, but haven't actually looked into what options are within the course. And that is something which varies from university to university. Yes, all of them follow the same accreditation standard with the same body. So for engineering, that's the Institution of Electronics Engineers, the IEEE accreditation standards for my course in particular. But it is an aspect which I think is often overlooked, which, since I had a deeply vested interest specifically in the program, meant that I was looking specifically for that. And Loughborough happened to be one of the few universities which said, all right, we're starting with this in the first 2 years, which meant by the time I went on placement, I already had almost the entire breadth of knowledge that was required for a very well-paying intern job. Great. And I think that really helped.
So I'll come back to you on the internship side and all, but if I sum it up for my students, I think what Raunak is saying is to definitely look at what content is offered within the program. It's worth discussing with the experts to ensure that the choice you are making will lead to a great career and a great choice of an institution. Thank you, Raunak. I'll come back to you. So coming back to you, Martyn, the other thing which, you know, most people are interested of late is, we spoke about the ranking, we spoke about the accreditation. What would you say in specific to Loughborough on the accreditations you have, which gives you the kind of ranking you have, offering and reassurance to our prospective students?
Thanks, Amit. I think that's a really good question, you know, for students and parents, because clearly, you know, wherever you study, you know, it's a huge investment in money, but also it's an emotional investment as well. And you want to get that choice right. So I think it's worth just saying a little bit first about accreditation. And I know there are accreditation bodies in India as well, but within the UK, you know, accreditation organizations, they're independent professional bodies. So they're not connected to any one university, and they test us on a number of key things. So coming back to the question earlier, they look at the content, the curriculum that we teach, to make sure it's relevant to what they think their industry needs and what the outside world needs. But increasingly, and I think this is good news for Indian students, accrediting bodies also test and measure us at Loughborough and other universities on how successful our graduates are. So, for example, how many graduates are in employment after graduation? What is their starting salaries? And in some cases, the accrediting body will look at the return on investment. They will look at the starting salary of a student before they did a program and after they've done a program as well, to make sure it's delivering value for money. So if I mention maybe just a few of the very specific accrediting bodies that we're associated with and other top universities are associated with, if we start with business schools. So in Loughborough's case, we're one of the few UK business schools to have what we call the AAA, the prestigious triple accreditation. And that's from three different international bodies. So two of these are global. The first is the Association to Advance Collegiate Schools of Business, which is called the short version AACSB. That's a global standard. The next, which some students may have heard of already, is AMBER. It's the Association of MBAs. And Loughborough Business School has been accredited by AMBER for over 30 years, so quite a long time. And then finally, there's a European quality standard, which all top European business schools have, which is called EQUIS. And then the other thing that Loughborough is very famous for, as Raunak mentioned, is engineering. So we are one of the largest engineering universities in the UK. You know, we literally have thousands of engineers studying, you know, academics as well, PhDs, undergrad students. And all of our degrees in engineering lead to a chartered engineering status with the UK Engineering Council. And it's just a final point as well. You mentioned rankings, Amit, and I think it is important to look at rankings. And one piece of advice I would always give to students and parents, you know, whether in India or in the UK or anywhere, you know, is to look at the domestic rankings. That's really important. Look at the global rankings overall, but also look at the subject rankings, because I think they're really important. Oxford and Cambridge are often the top two universities in the UK, but they're not number one for every subject. So not every student may want to go there or could go there, or might find that their program is actually taught better somewhere else. So in Loughborough's case, globally, you know, we're number one in the QS for sport-related subjects, but we're also in the top 200, even top 100 for 11 other subjects. And that includes business and management, art and design, civil engineering, and mechanical engineering. So I think it can seem a little bit scary, but I think it's really important for parents and students to look at the accreditation bodies, because that's an independent measure of quality. And then when looking at the different rankings, really look at that subject ranking as well. Because as Raunak said, the choice of program is really important, and you need to make sure you enjoy the program, but also it's going to be recognized by employers afterwards. True.
Thank you for your comments on the accreditation side, because gradually my sense is more and more students are sensitive around this information. They value the ratings and the rankings of the institution. They value the accreditations which institutions enjoy. Now, I'll bring another important aspect, which is to do with the internship. And this is, in a way, linked to the ROI, which, of course, every student, every parent is interested in. And I also have Raunak also to pitch in at one point. But from your experience, Martyn, internships do play a role. Part-time work do play a role. How do you look at, in the current times, I mean, if I say how easy it is for the students to come into a UK university and grab an internship or find a good part-time job while they're pursuing education. So what would be your comments?
So I think that's a really good question, Amit. And the first thing I would say to any student and parent about any aspect of studying in the UK, but particularly this one, because it is really important, I think, is that UK universities have been welcoming international students, welcoming Indian students now, in some cases, for literally over 100 years. I think our first graduates and Indian students at Loughborough were back in the 1940s and 50s, not long after World War II, so quite a long time ago. So we are used to supporting international students, supporting Indian students, and we've invested quite heavily in the last 5 years because we've seen more international students come to Loughborough, which is fantastic. We see more Indian students come to Loughborough. So what you will find is that in the UK, again, because of the point I mentioned earlier about accreditation, but also the UK government and their scrutiny of universities, they expect us to support our graduates, to find internships, find part-time work, both on and off campus, and also post-graduation. So at Loughborough, we have a dedicated international employability and career service. So we have services for UK students, but also obviously international students might have different needs. And also, we want to help students when they go back to their home country or go to a third country as well, whether that might be Dubai or somewhere like that. So it's not just about understanding the UK job market and preparing students for interviews, resumes, etc., but also what they want to do afterwards. So once a student graduates from Loughborough, they can actually access that support from us for up to 5 years after they graduate as well. So that's great. So to give some other practical examples, we are a campus university, one of the biggest in the UK and Europe. Twice a year, we have the largest UK careers fair, employment fair in the UK of any university. So we bring about 100 companies onto our campus in the big hall, and they can meet all our students, and the students can find out about internships and post-study work. A big factor about our undergraduate study, which I think Raunak will talk about, is that every single one of our degrees offers a placement year. And in fact, in our business school, it's compulsory. It's a four-year degree because we find that students are so successful when they've done an internship, we made it compulsory for them to get the full benefit. But there are other, more innovative ways as well. We do micro-internships, online internships, in-person internships. Loughborough also has, we're very fortunate, we have a science and enterprise park, which I know a lot of Indian universities, the IITs also have, where companies, startups, but also other businesses can come and rent space. And so there are opportunities on campus, not to just work part-time maybe in the university itself, but also work with these external companies and businesses on short internships, on placements. And I just want to mention as well, our London campus, which we might talk a little bit about, but our London campus is in a very unique location. It's on the London 2012 Olympic Park, in what is a tech hub, a startup hub. And so our students at that campus, who are master's students, from day one, they can go into a collaborative project where they go and work with a company on a live project. It could be a marketing plan or a new product launch. and they work as part of a project team as well. So I think I would say that, as you can see from the Loughborough example, lots of opportunities for UK students to get, for international students in the UK, I should say, to get lots of opportunities for paid internships, but also develop their skills, and then, you know, make the most of the graduate visa route, which we might talk a little bit about as well, which is the opportunity to, you know, stay in the UK for at least 2 years after they graduate and get paid employment.
So my question to Raunak is basically, because he has been a student in UK at Loughborough, what has been your experience, Raunak, being an intern at one point? Possibly you would have taken up some part-time jobs as well. So how university has been able to give you support, and what has been your experience on these opportunities?
Thanks for the question. I'll come to that one by one. So firstly, with the internship, I think it's something that every student wants to have some practical work with, especially when it's a field that is like engineering, where we have a lot of hours that are spent during the course on technical material. Everyone just looks forward to that 1 year where you can actually go into industry and make use of what you've learned for the first 2 or first 3 years, depending on the order of the program that you're in, on a real product or on a real project. In my case, that happened to be between the second and the third year. And that was probably the biggest motivation for everyone from my batch who decided to go out and do a placement and look for a placement. In my case, that happened to be at Ocado Technology. It's a grocery retail company which uses a very high degree of automation in their warehouses. And as a student in robotics, that meant I got to work on some of the most, some of the fastest robotic automation systems used in retail anywhere in the world, which was an incredible experience. And that's one aspect of it. The fact that it is also equally difficult for students to secure these lucrative placements means that there was a lot of help from the department as well as from Careers Network, which helps students at Loughborough to go through their CVs, prepare for mock interviews, and actually narrow down their listing. So I had a lot of help both from the engineering department as well as from the General Careers Network, which the university provides support with.
That's really heartening to hear from you, because students who choose programs which has got internship would seek this kind of, you know, validation. And I think your comments are really helpful for our prospective students. Please go ahead. Yeah.
Exactly. I totally agree with that, because when I got to the UK, I didn't really have any friends or family over here because I'm an international student. Never been to this country before, so I had no idea what the work ethic was like. It's only what you read about online that you can kind of try and get an idea about. But the university was actually really helpful with giving us all an idea of what to prepare for and what specifically to target when looking for these placement options. Once again, a lot of placements have a very broad scope, so it could be something as broad as hardware, which people from maybe 4 or 5 different courses could be applying for. You have all the way from mechanical engineers to electrical engineers. Somehow, when you're in robotics, it's at a very narrow crossroads between 3 of these different fields, mechanical, electrical, and software. And that was actually a bit confusing, because you start looking for placements in all these 3 sectors, when in reality, there is a very specific niche that's already available that you just don't know about, that you can actually go straight in there and apply for. And if you do, you have an advantage. But as a student coming in, you don't know that. So it really helped that there was already someone who had coached previous students from previous batches of the same program to go ahead and do that. That's one part of it. The other aspect is, of course, when I came back from my placement, I realized that having gone ahead into the industry and worked on some of these projects helped to choose electives, which then contribute towards your final year dissertation and thesis projects. So just as an example, when I was working at Ocado Technology, the team that I was in involved software simulation. And after coming back and joining Part C, which is the third year of studies, so the year immediately after the placement at university, I had a couple of module options. And those would have affected what project I was choosing to work on for my final year dissertation. And it actually really helped that I'd already worked for a year on these simulation models, because I eventually chose to do a very large portion of my project in simulation first. And that really sped up the entire process afterwards. So I'm still working on the project right now. I'm working on my dissertation just this morning, in fact. And I can say with confidence that it has helped quite a lot, because I have peers who did not choose to go on placement and decided to progress straight from second year into third year. And there is a marked difference between the way that we approach our work.
Fantastic. So the other thing which I would like to bring Martyn in and ask basically is, we've been hearing a lot of concerns with regard to ROI, concerns around accommodations, concerns around living costs, and of course, things which are related to these aspects. And I would like, Martyn, if you can comment for the benefit of students, because a lot of things which are hearsay for the students, they may not know what the reality is. Whereas I know there's a lot of support for students, as Raunak also mentioned. So if you can share your thoughts, how the sector supports these students, how quickly they can start to look at the ROIs, and what, if at all, there are any challenges on accommodation, because you are best placed to comment from where you are.
Thanks, Amit. So I'll maybe talk first about, you know, we've talked a lot about the academics and the quality of the UK for academics and how that's managed by the government, how it's managed by different, you know, monitored by different rankings and accreditation bodies. And I think, you know, we've also talked about maybe all the fantastic employability career support that students can benefit from and access in the UK. But there are other things as well. And one of them is a students' union, which is something that, you know, is a big part of Loughborough, but also I think every university in the UK, all 160, will have a students' union. And the thing that I would say about the students' union, why I would encourage students and also their parents to encourage students to engage with the students' union, is because, again, from an employer point of view, you know, I employ graduates, and to be really frank, I don't want to work with robots. I think humans like to work with other humans. They want to work with people that can interact and have soft skills, can solve problems, can be part of a team. And that's where the student union and getting active with the students union can really help. You know, we talk about students that are well-rounded, and what we mean by that are not just students that, you know, maybe sit and work on their academics, that is important, but also that go out there and meet new people and engage with a range of different activities, you know, to get the full benefit of living in a new country, get the full experience so that they grow, they mature, and that gives them the edge, the extra skills and confidence that they can use when they're in a job interview or when they're applying for a job. So our students' union, it's a building, but also a service run by students for students, and they organize lots of different activities. So for example, you know, students can get involved with local charities. They can help raise money for different charities. Loughborough Students' Union Charity Society has raised over £1 million each year for charity, which is a huge amount of money. They also offer opportunities to volunteer with different groups in the local community. So students at Loughborough have volunteered over, you know, about tens of thousands of hours each year through volunteering. And the student union also organises social events that bring UK and international students together. So I always encourage students, whether they're UK students or international students, to get involved with the students union. In terms of wider support, you know, we've talked about employability, but clearly studying overseas, you know, can seem a bit scary. You know, I'm a father myself. If I was sending my sons thousands of miles overseas, I want them to be well looked after. And for many international students, as Raunak mentioned, it's their first time away from their families. For many, it's their first time in the UK. And they're also studying in a different culture, different education system. But we know this. As I mentioned earlier, we've been welcoming international students at Loughborough for around 100 years. And it's the same with other UK universities. So we've put in place lots of dedicated support, whether that's maybe around extra study skills, English language, how to write essays, how to prepare presentations. maybe help with mathematics and statistics if students aren't maybe, I'm an arts graduate, so I don't like maths and statistics. So we can have extra support there. But really it's about, you know, making sure that students have that full experience. And I think if students do feel a little bit homesick, if they feel anxious, maybe a little bit stressed during exam periods, you know, we've always got someone to talk to. We have trained counselling staff as well. And the final thing I want to mention, I think I have to mention this because it's Loughborough and it's sport, but obviously every university across the UK has some sort of sport activities. Loughborough is number one in the world for sport. So we do have, yes, we have elite Olympic athletes. We even have elite Indian elite Olympic athletes that train with us and study with us. But the most important thing to say is that a huge amount of the sport that we do is recreational. It's about participation. Students do not have to be sporty or even like sport to come and study at Loughborough. It's not compulsory. And many students are not sporty. But clearly, you know, recreational sport, exercise, it's great for well-being, you know, particularly when you've got exams or assignments due in. But again, it's a great way to meet students from other parts of the world and from the UK and to develop the confidence, resilience, communication skills, team skills. So if students do want to come to the UK, but particularly Loughborough, and get and try a different sport just to make friends, just for fun, then that's something where we've got, you know, fantastic facilities, coaches, etc. as well. So there's lots of activities, as I said, that students can access, which perhaps they weren't aware of and their parents weren't aware of because we focus a lot on the academic quality. But I would always encourage graduates, because on your resume, then you can talk about it. But also, as Raunak said, with his industry experience, you can use this experience, the volunteering, the charity experience, working with people from different backgrounds, talking to people, you know, working in a team. That's really valuable. And there's no other way to get that. You won't just get that from a book or from a, you know, an academic journal. You've got to live that experience as well.
That's true. I think UK does offer great in terms of support in all these aspects. Now, other thing which I'm sure you are well aware, students are extremely interested to know and hear is around scholarships. And I think it'll be appropriate to know from you at this point in time, where we do see some policy announcements being made by Government of UK in recent past. What kind of scholarships, you know, you think Loughborough offers, which are available for Indian students? And if you can also speak a little about other big scholarships offered by different trusts, managed by Great Campaign or British Council and kind of things, that will be really helpful for our students while they are on this journey to choose UK as their choice of destination.
Thanks, Amit. So I think, again, Loughborough certainly, but most, you know, UK universities, if not all, you know, really value international students because they bring so much to a campus, so much diversity and so much life and vibrancy and different perspectives. Our new university strategy, we've got a new vice chancellor, has a very clear ambition to be more internationally engaged, even more internationally engaged. And India is a key country for us. We have so many Indian alumni. We have some really long-standing academic partnerships with Indian universities. So our partnership in engineering with IIT Delhi, for example, goes back almost 50 years. So to support this, you know, we have made sure we've got financial aid through a number of different scholarships to support students in coming to the UK and coming to study at Loughborough. So, for example, for undergraduates, we have a 25% tuition fee scholarship for the first year of their study. And that's for students that have got, you know, strong grades in their high school exams, their Indian Year 12 exams. That's in place for all our undergraduate degrees. For postgraduate students, for master's students, we've recently launched a very prestigious new scholarship called the Loughborough University Global Impact Scholarship. And that is a high value award. It's for 50%, but even up to 100% of the tuition fee for master's programs. And obviously applicants need to have a strong academic background and performance, but they also need to show us that they are going to use that knowledge from their master's to contribute to the development of their home country or the host country they go and live in after they graduate. And I mentioned at the beginning, you know, UK universities, they they have a really strong mission and sense of purpose. You know, a lot of our programs relate to, you know, climate change and net zero and renewables and AI. And so we want students to use that knowledge from their program to make the world a better place. And that's what this scholarship is designed to do. But we also have some slightly lower scholarships, but still generous scholarships for other master's students who maybe don't manage to get the Global Impact Scholarship. So our Excellence Scholarship is 20% of the tuition fee. And that's for students that have achieved the equivalent of a first class undergraduate degree. And with that, there's no application process, no additional application process. Students are automatically considered for this. And I think UK universities, as I say, they do recognize that studying overseas is expensive. But equally, they want to encourage more international students to bring that life to the university. And so scholarships, along with part-time work and employment support, is one way that UK universities can really help Indian students and their parents and families, you know, reduce the cost and manage that cost of their investment.
Great. Thank you for your comments around scholarships. One element which I would like Raunak to talk about is, I know he said he has spent a few years now at Loughborough, so I want him to express his thoughts of being in Loughborough. He cannot talk about the subject which he's pursuing, but more about the place as such and the support he has seen over these years from locals, from his classmates, colleagues, friends, life in Loughborough. If you can talk a little bit about Raunak.
That's an interesting question. During the first year that I joined, it was considerably tougher because that was at the peak of COVID. Socializing was practically out of the question for most of the year. But in the second year, all of that turned around completely. And I actually had a much better experience as a student with exploring places around the town as well in the second year, because we could actually plan things for the weekend. Maybe that went with either flatmates who I had been living with or with people from my course who I was working on with for projects, because usually the first social circle that you make is going to be the people you live with in the same flat. I was in student accommodation in the first 2 years and shifted off campus just this year, in fact. So I can't testify to the fact that, okay, you know what, your flatmates are probably going to be the first 5 to 6 people once you move to a new country that you actually grow really close to. And I'm still in touch with many of them from back in first year. But going around and exploring the places was more of a thing in second year. Fast forward beyond my placement, because I've already spoken about that, to this year. And that experience changed completely because I decided to join a student society. This was something that I hadn't really explored earlier. Student societies fall under the Loughborough Students Union. And the one that I happened to join was for dance, because I am not really a sporty type. I do play recreational basketball on and off. But if I had to choose between that and dancing, I would dance any day. So I joined the Salsa Society on a whim and on a recommendation from a friend, because they had tried it out. The friend in question wasn't even here because they had graduated. But I decided to go anyway. Made it into the competition team and actually had a completely new social circle of just people who love to dance. And now I end up spending a lot of time either on the weekends with them, because it's one of those things wherein, unlike a sport, I would like to think that dance is just free therapy. So, spending the whole day in the workshop working on a dissertation, at the end of the day, you want to find something to socialize, but not necessarily get out of town and go to another city to do. Yes, there are options to do that as well, because Nottingham is just 20 minutes north by train. Leicester is about 10 minutes south. We do go there as well, especially when there's a long weekend. But if it's just for the evening, meet up somewhere, maybe at a cafe in town, or just at an open space, put on some music and dance. And I think that's probably contributed the most towards my social experience as a student.
So if I sum it up for people, I think your stint and stay has been so far really enjoyable.
It's been very interesting and very diverse.
No, that's really heartening to hear. That's really heartening to hear from someone who has spent a few years in UK now and went in COVID, seen that struggle also of being confined into one room with some roommates in a way. So really heartening. I'll come back to Martyn and I'll ask one last question, which is a combination. I want, Martyn, if you can comment about when people pick up Loughborough as a university, your London campus or at Loughborough, you know, why they should choose between the two. Of course, every campus has got its strengths. And then to conclude, if you can say a few things, which in these changing times, the students and parents should be mindful while they are committing towards a particular program, institution in the UK, and they are geared for the autumn 2024 intake.
Thanks, Amit. So I think what I might do is just say a little bit first about, which we haven't talked about, is about accommodation, because that's obviously so important to get, you know, affordable accommodation, but accommodation where you feel safe, secure. And as Raunak said earlier, you know, you're living with other students, you can meet, you know, other students, particularly international students who are going through a similar experience. So if I maybe give an example of our Loughborough campus first. So we have two campuses. The first is our main campus, our oldest campus, which is in Loughborough, which is a town. It's quite a small town, but it's a very historic town. I think it's well over 1,000 years old. It's very close to the cities of Nottingham and Leicester, but actually London, the fastest trains take about 1 hour, 15 minutes. So it's quite accessible from London. It's to the north of London. Loughborough is where we have our undergraduate programs, our postgraduate programs and PhD programs. And we actually have 17 different halls of residence with nearly 6,000 rooms for undergraduate and postgraduate students. And we have catered and self-catered, so where students make their own food or where the university provides food. And we also have ensuite or shared bathroom. And the halls culture at Loughborough is quite unique. So each hall has a committee of students, which is really like a small family or community that help to organize social events and sporting events. We have hall wardens and sub wardens. So these are actual staff that work for the university based in the halls. So if students have any problems 24/7, they're there to help them. We also have, you know, a lot of security on campus. Not that we need it. Loughborough is a very safe place, but we do have our own security. So if students have any issues, they always feel safe and secure. I also think, what I was just going to mention as well is about the culture at Loughborough, the hall culture. It is quite unique. It's a bit like the college or maybe Oxford or Cambridge or the hall culture in the US. So each hall has a sense of identity. And when you meet alumni, maybe that studied 30, 40, 50 years ago, the first thing they will say to each other is, which hall did you study in? Yeah. My hall was the best. So it's really friendly. It's quite fun. It's really friendly. But what I would say about just generally about accommodation in the UK, and Loughborough is certainly true of Loughborough, if a student applies to us, if they get an offer of admission, if they make us their firm choice, if they accept their offer and they register for accommodation before the deadline, then we will guarantee them a place in university managed accommodation, which for master's students is 1 year. And for undergraduate students, we will guarantee 2 years of university accommodation. So that's our East Midlands campus in Loughborough. And then our London campus, which you mentioned, it's a postgraduate campus. So it's for master's students or PhD students. It's around 7 minutes by train from the centre of London. It's on the Olympic Park, which was the site of the London 2012 Olympics. And we work there with a local reputable private accommodation provider. And we have an agreement which guarantees a large number, several hundred rooms, which we can then allocate to students when they make us their firm choice. So I know in the past there have been, you know, negative news coverage about maybe some areas of the UK where there are, you know, challenges finding accommodation. I think that that problem is less of an issue now. And certainly for Loughborough, it hasn't been an issue because we either own our own accommodation or we have these long-standing partnerships with accommodation providers as well. So I think that's about accommodation, which is really important. I think just a few other things I would maybe, you know, suggestions and tips that I would give to parents and students, just more generally. You know, we've talked a lot about rankings, and I do think they are important. As I said before, you know, do look at the domestic rankings. So some of them include the Times, Sunday Times, the Guardian, the Complete University Guide. Look at the overall ranking, but do look at the subject ranking, because you might find that for the subject you want to do, it may not always be the university you first thought of is the best for that subject. And that means they have a really strong reputation for producing graduates in that subject. They have really good outcomes for graduates, good ROI, good reputation with employers, both in the UK and internationally. I think as well, thinking about the type of university you want. So I mentioned we are a campus university, you know, where everything is in one location. But also in the UK, we have city or urban universities. So a good example of that would be Manchester, a very famous university, where the university buildings are sort of scattered across the city. And obviously, there's, you know, there's pros and cons to both. And I think, you know, think about then about location. Do you want a big city? Do you want somewhere that's a bit more rural, a bit more green, less busy? Do you want to be by the coast or by the mountains? You know, the UK has a wide range of different environments, and it really depends what the students want. I would always encourage students, if they can, to try and visit before they study. I do appreciate that can be hard. It can be expensive. Students might be studying or working. But if even if you can't maybe visit, I think, you know, these days with technology, there's lots of opportunities to try and get a sense of what the university looks like through Instagram, through virtual tours, through virtual open days, activities such as this with some of our trusted representatives, our social media accounts, where we often have our current student ambassadors producing content and sharing their own stories. And I'll also talk to maybe some alumni. You know, we arrange conversations between our alumni in India and our current Indian students and our offer holders as well. So it's really about, if I was a student, thinking, you know, asking myself, can I imagine myself being there? You know, do I think I would belong? You know, can I envisage myself, you know, enjoying that university and that location? You know, but it's a big decision. And I would just say, take your time and try and get as much information as you can.
Lovely. I think you have said a lot of things which are of interest to the students. Very well spoke about the support which is available at the institution, the accreditation, the choices, the scholarship, the accommodation. I think it's very reassuring for the students to hear from someone like you, who has been into international education, global mobility of students for about 2 decades now, with your expertise and experience. I'm sure students will benefit from this conversation. Thank you, Raunak, for sharing your experience. You have spent a very decent amount of time. You have a successful internship in hand, and I'm sure you'll have a great future once you complete your qualifications at Loughborough. I am thankful to both of you for coming on this platform, sharing your experience and expertise with our prospective students. I'm sure they'll find it very, very useful. So thank you so very much to both of you. And thanks for your support.
Thank you, Amit. It's been a pleasure.